How you address the child is definitely a test. You swear your child, you will pay a price in the eyes of Allah. You must empower the child with loving words, encouraging words. Did you know that when you tell your child you are stupid, you are ugly, you're a failure, you keep on repeating that, they begin to believe that. And the opposite is true when you tell them you're beautiful, you're successful, you can do it, you're amazing, and I love you so much, they begin to believe that. And they're empowered and more confident. Check it out. You can see it. So my brothers, my sisters, something amazing is that a child is more like an empty vessel at the beginning, and you fill that vessel with a lot of things. Let them be good things. The way you speak, the way you interact, the way you care for the child, all has an impact in building the family unit to begin with. You didn't have time for your child. You never were there for the child, listening to the issues, the problems, communicating, developing a friendship as well as a relationship with your own children. You would never be able to guarantee their beautiful upbringing. You need to make good decisions regarding these children. But still, when you've made brilliant decisions, you've brought them up, you've spoken, you've been very fair. You know, in the case of divorce, and in the case of where someone has passed away, a lot of the times there is a battle. There is push and shove. People want to take the kids and prove a point without looking at what is best for the children. They want to be arrogant by trying to prove a point to the other spouse that I'm going to fix you. Perhaps you're not going to see these kids. Wallahi, those kids grow up with a parental deficit that plays out later on in their lives in different ways. Don't do that. It's your test. You destroy the fabric of the family unit completely. In a very bad way, because divorce is permissible, but the games that we play thereafter are haram. May Allah help us. We should not play games with the lives of the children, not at all. And vice versa, whatever the rights are, we fulfill in the most beautiful way. We should help and encourage the child to visit that child's other parent. You don't need to say nasty things. When you have a problem in the family and you've broken up completely and you've divorced totally, you don't need to involve your children in it in a way that you start telling them about negative things about their own parent. How do you think they will grow up? No matter what happened, say a few positive things. Encourage them to have a relationship unless they were total abusers. And unless it is really and truly feared that these children will suffer a consequence of developing a relationship with that person because of the criminal behavior of the person, then it's an exception.